We'll dance till no one's left. I don't wanna blink my eyes. I don't wanna miss a thing. I can't wait for you to be my wife, to live this life together. You to know that you were my heart forever.
Sneaky once, not even once. She never lied to me at all, but I say I do 2 weeks ago, and listen to this sneaky shit she pulled on me. I want to drive to Oklahoma. She's like all adamant about wanting to drive to Oklahoma, and I'm like, all right, whatever, I'll drive home. But my dumb ass didn't think about, oh, I'm gonna be up in the mountains for 12 days hiking around with the crazy ass hillbillies getting my ass whooped, and I'm gonna have to drive home after I just got killed in the mountains. And what's she gonna be doing? Sleeping. All the trust is gone. Yep. Look at her over here. She thinks it's a joke. Ain't no joke. Why are you crying over there? Because I don't trust you anymore, huh? You all right, Franklin?
Oh my God, I can't believe it. It's not sneaky.
Sneaky. Sneaky ass girl. That's all I gotta say. Watch out for him.
Yeah, that's the fish of the day.
Yeah, baby! Listen to Keith, he put me right on the spot. I herd cows on my part-time.
For him and me, this is an awesome car ride. Blow your call, Eric.
Let's see if I get it.
That Eric has mastered a cow call in just the last 100 miles. Monique now, on the other hand, we've got another 100 to go, I'm afraid.
We arrived about, 1:30 a.m.? Or 12:30 mountain time, actually. But, camped out on the ground, on the gravel, you know. In the middle of nowhere, we just threw out some beanbags. Now, we're packing up, getting ready to go on.
Where are we going? Kind of explain to me where we're going.
We're gonna hike into base camp and we're gonna kill a bull this afternoon. You betcha. It's 10 o'clock mountain time. We are heading into the mountains. We're in. Hour two, I think. Man, it's beautiful. Mountains gorgeous, streams are gorgeous, weather is perfect. Shoulders kind of burning from holding my bow, but I'll be ready when he walks out. Never know.
See ya. Honeymoon, baby. This is how it's supposed to be.
And this is what we've been hiking for. First hunt. Probably can't see us.
It's alright. We only burnt 7,000 calories yesterday. 16 miles. In this hairy shit.
And guess what? We're here out bugling. It's awesome. We got two. We're trekking down. Like steep as junk. Hope we get one. Wish us luck. Yesterday we almost died. Died. I was almost done, but we made it to camp. That was the hardest thing we ever did. We're out. To hell.
Made it down this very steep slope. And guess what we were surprised with? Look how beautiful this is. Every tough road, there's something beautiful at the end.
Alright, we're live. From the side of the mountain. And there's an elk. Just bugled back.
Get your boat. I only went in that far.
No, that's it, buddy. You're behind the shoulder.
I think.
All right. Pull down. Eric. Oh, my God. Eric just shot a bull. I think he's down. He's down near rumbling. He came in from our left side. We called him in. Holy shit. It was a nice size bull. It was big. I hope he got him. I hear some rumbling down there like he's hurting.
There he is. He's dying. He's dead.
Yeah.
I see.
BBD. BBD.
We can't wait to go get him.
Right there.
All right, Eric, tell us what happened.
Well, we were coming up and he...
What day is it?
It's Wednesday. It's our first day hunting.
No, today's Thursday.
Today's Thursday, our first day hunting. Anyway, it's our first day hunting. I don't know what day it is.
First morning.
Yeah. First morning. And we came up here, and he did the little cow.
Meow.
And
that's a cat.
Cow.
Meow.
Whatever. He did his little deal. And he did his bugle right there.
Right there at about 80, 90 yards.
Yeah.
He growled. He didn't bugle.
He growled. It was a growl? Okay, well, he growled. And then and I was about to do it, and then I went to tighten up. And he went like that again.
Yeah.
And then he would turn his head like this, like he was going to walk. But you can see his eyeball looking at me.
Like a big tuna eyeball.
Well, he's like, he's trying to trick. I guess they're trying to trick you. Thinking he's looking down. Wow. That was unbelievable. I hope I made a good shot.
Think there's a lot of rumbling down there.
There was a lot of rumbling.
Yeah, but that might just be him running.
I seen his antlers.
They debating on what's going on. I came looking for blood. And guess what? Blood is what I found.
Oh my God. You are a blessed man.
Holy shit, Eric, he's huge.
I'm in shock. That's what's going on right now. Earlier I was in fear because I didn't know if I hit him good enough to kill him. Now I'm in absolute shock. You hear that one bugling?
This way. I had about a 10-yard shot, put it right in his shoulder blade, but luckily I was packing some heat and went through it.
How lucky is that, Mo, to get a scratch your tag?
Mm-hmm.
Day one. All because of Larry and Keith.
And Mo, he just forgets the most important part. And our journey begins. Our track back with some loins and the head. It's going to be a tough one. We already had to take a break 2 minutes into it. But we're going to do it. Poor Eric. Got the head on his back, struggling.
I have a whole level of respect for him.
Look at him. Eric, how you doing?
I'm good.
Alright. Lesson one. Like coon asses, don't make it to God's country often. Living below sea level will whip your butt when you come up to 11,600 feet and I'm barely moving. As you can see, I get up to 2 miles per hour. That is top speed for me. Top speed is 2 miles per hour. That means every hike we do is forever. Lesson two. Why don't bring coon asses to God's country? There's a good chance we're going to get lost because we're so slow. Alright, lesson three. Why coon asses shouldn't come to God's country? Don't kill elk 4 miles away from camp. That means you got a 16-mile day. And as you can see, we are sucking wind.
It's one of the best days of my life and one of the worst days. All wrapped up in one.
All the struggles we went through yesterday, getting up here, paid off this morning. When that big bull came in, we was not even thinking he was that close. We did a bugle, he replied right there, and it was game on. Eric's stuff, I'm proud of him. Next is mine.
Alright. Mo and Eric, we're out by ourselves. There's a glass.
We are natural born elk.
There's two of them.
We're just doing some scouting for this afternoon hunt when our boys get back. But there's definitely a stud down there that I'm going to get. So this morning we heard a bull on this ridge and we think he topped over onto the other side. So now we're working around the edge of the cliff. You know, it's real safe. We just got told we could die if we fall off. Word from the wise. So, hopefully we get on them. We have been busting our balls.
It would mess the whole trip up.
Yeah, it would mess the trip up. Everybody would be out $600.
Let's rage.
I knew you were gonna come to me.
And here you are,
but you better choose carefully.
'Cause I'm
capable of anything, and everything.
Make me your Aphrodite. Make me your one and only.
Don't you know what you're falling for. Baby, do you dare to do this? 'Cause I'm coming at you like a dark horse. Hey! Are you ready?
Going back.
Monique, he just crashed, huh?
Good shot.
Oh, yes.
Not that deep in him.
I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud of you. You know how long you held that for? Give me five. You are awesome. She held it forever.
At least 2 minutes.
Was he staring at me?
This is what it's for. Oh, huffing and puffing. Inside burning. I'm chasing the greens through the hills. Right here. Check him out. He has big eye guard, just like I wanted.
He's got a lot of big stuff.
He does. Nice bull, Mo.
Walked right in my spot where, you know, I envisioned he would come and swat. BBD.
Beast like that,
the moment I've been waiting for. You see anything behind me? They're big, huh? A little top heavy.
Coon asked for his guide country. When you have mules, set the pride aside and let them carry your antlers, because it will take you 4 hours to get to camp, which should take you an hour. But I'm gonna do it. It's a dream, and I'm gonna do it.
Hey Mo, what you chewing on?
Some Jack Link's sriracha stick. It's so good. Just what you need after you carry your elk back. Come on, Dad, answer.
Dad! Guess what? I killed an elk. It's really big. Alright. Lesson 7. Why coon asses shouldn't mess with God's country or its animals. When a mule is pissed off, keep it tied up and let it be pissed off, because he will kick your butt getting up that hill right there. You got no chance at all. And if our buddies would have came back and saw Smokey 6 miles down the trail, we would have been up Schitt's Creek. And they wouldn't want us to hunt with them anymore. So, keep, moral of the story, keep the pissed off mule tied up. Just feed him water and some grass. The end. Alright, we're Tuesday. What's the date? 9th. We've been stuck in camp all morning. It's about 3 p.m. It's been storming. We're up in the clouds right now. There's a bad front pushing in, but we got a break in the weather. We geared up, we're heading out. Hopefully we'll get one. It's Larry and Keith's turn.
Yeah.
black and white. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. But you can't see what those shades of gray keep covered. You should have seen it in color. But you can't see what those shades of gray keep covered. You should have seen it in color.